doing is spreading out another layer of the metallic acrylic paint. And I will let this dry. Sorry, I was so quiet earlier. There was a lot going on in the background. Okay, so this is all spread out nice and even. And I'm going to let that dry, and I'll be right back. Okay, my next thing is going to be to try to use some of this, and see what happens. Do me a favor and turn off the TV. I think I'm going to try to fill these all the way in either. I think it'll look cool. Some of them are only partially filled in. I really like the way this part of the stencil looks here, so... Get a little bit down here in the corner. Go now. I'm going to wash these things. And I'll be right back. Okay, I think what I'm going to do is try to put some words on the background here. And I'm going to use this stamp set. And I don't remember who it's from. Maybe if you see it, you'll know who it's from. I think it's Gypsies. Five Gypsies? Seven Gypsies? I can't remember what the name is. I think that's who made it. I'm not going to try to get it all the way. And let's see what else I put in there. Okay. Let's call that good enough for that. Okay, so that's a little bit of background stuff going on. Let's see if that's good. Yeah, I think that's good for now. So we'll move on and just keep going until... Well, we think we're good. I don't know if I'm going to add a bumblebee. I think I am going to add a couple bumblebees. And I don't know if I'm going to add some butterflies or not. I could. I definitely could. I don't know if you can hear the dog snoring or not. Alright, when I decide what I'm going to do next, I will come back. Okay, so I've let this dry. Now I've decided that I want to try to see if I can't change the color of the modeling paste, the Liquitex. I'll get back on that better. Liquitex that I used to make the honey foam. So I'm going to take some distress markers. And that's distress markers. Color them onto a block. It's a foam brush. Eric, can you get me a little bit of water, just a small, like one of these of water? Get a little bit of mustard seed. Try that too. Around a little bit. I'm also wondering how well this works as a painting medium. Let's see. Okay. Okay, now we're just going to let that dry. Be right back, we're going to let that dry. Okay, so I had an idea for the little bumblebees.
Alright.
So what I've done is stamp them, let it dry. So I've got the B stamped and he's nice and dry now. I'm going to take the yellow, it's called mustard seed, and I'm going to color his body a little bit. I'm going to use my jelly roll pen to do the wings a little bit. And then on top of the white, I'm going to try, I don't know how this is going to work, using my stylus to apply a little bit of the Distress Crackle Medium. And I'm going to put some of the crackle medium over each of the honeycomb areas, too. It's not going to be perfect, but that's not the plan here anyway, so it works out. I don't want it on all of them. Just a lot of them. There we go. I'll let those dry. See what happens. Alright, so we'll come back after that's all dry. Okay, my next step is to take these words that I printed off on the computer onto transparency and put them on excuse me, onto the project. That's going to go here. Oops. That's going to go there. And I'm going to wait because that's still wet. So I'm going to show you with the last. That right here. Then I'm going to take a piercing tool. I've got a piercing tool here. And I'm going to put brads in to hold the words onto the paper. So see how that's working? Let me get this out of the way. See? So I'm going to get those all, I'm going to let this all dry. Can you see all the crackling happening? I don't know if you can or not. Maybe you can in that one. Maybe a little bit. Okay, I'm going to let this finish drying and then we'll move on to the next step. And then while it's drying, I'm going to get these all adhered down. Okay, so this is how far we are now. I did these bees the exact same way I did these, by stamping them, and then on the back side, I stamped on the back side so that it's not going to scratch off. And I colored in the wings and colored in the bodies the same way that I did here, using the white jelly roll pen and the one of the yellow Tim Holtz distress markers. The crackle has continued to crackle more. Can you see? It's pretty cool. And then I adhered the clear words with the brads, and I've used some brads here and there to adhere the film strip also. Now I'm just putting brads onto the side of the page, and I've selected some out from my stash, and I'm going to put these in a row. On the paper also. And then when I finished doing that, my next step is going to be to add a little bit of decoration, I guess, to the word windows here. This one, this one, I'll go all the way across. I think it might be better if it's more hand done. And it's probably going to be easier too. Doodled. So I'm going to do that to all of them. And maybe I will add a little bit of gold. There we go. So I'm going to continue on that and I will be done. So I'll be back with the finished piece. Okay, so this is, we're nearly finished. All I'm going to do is add a date to it. And I'm using the that's interesting. I'm using the Smash. There we go. So, there we are. There we have it. See you later. Bye.